Hi, I'm Andrew Watson from Creative Guitar Studio. Thanks for joining me for another one of my guitar masterclasses. You know, there are a lot of guitar students who will have difficulty when they're connecting scales to create melodies. And most of the problem will stem from the challenges in being able to link longer melodic lines. However, if we can practice the studies that will involve learning how to view and apply the scales in a more larger horizontal way, a more lateral way, this will allow the typical in-position scale that would normally cover maybe 4 or 5 frets to cover even upwards of 9 or more frets on the guitar neck. Another helpful exercise involves building repetitive rhythmic grooves. Most people don't stop and consider how having a flowing, recurring rhythmic groove can really push the flow of a line along and have it function in a more longer, wider way along the neck. Now, this plays a big role for melodies because it'll allow the flow of the line to be more connected, and thus it'll wind up being longer as you stretch it across the neck as you're pursuing that recurring rhythmic flow. So what I want to do in this lesson is we're going to break down both of these topics and these ideas, and we're going to study how the practice of forming and connecting longer guitar lines can really change the way you build melodies and compose improvisation ideas along the span of the entire guitar fingerboard. Well, as practicing guitar players, we generally begin our scale training by working on the traditional in-position scale pattern. So I'm going to start this lesson by just playing through a simple shape like this. It's in example number 1A of your handout. It goes like this. Just a simple G major scale found off of the 4th guitar string, 5th fret G. Right, very common shape, probably you know it already. And while you're in a position like that, working on a scale shape, it's a nice way to get started with things and all that, and it's a great way to begin gaining a working knowledge for fingerboard scale patterns. They tend to be an easier way to memorize like that, but at the same time, they tend to also kind of lock us up within just a small fretting position. So what happens usually after learning those kinds of shapes, you move on into the type of shape that we're going to find in example number 1B. Now this is one here that uses an in-position area of the neck to start and begin moving more laterally out of. It involves just basically sliding along to adjacent strings. So it's in your handout under example 1B. It goes like this. You can tell there what's happening is we're just moving position by way of a slide. Simple as that. So, those are usually the early days of just, getting away from being in position, using slides to, move through and across what we'll sometimes call 4-note per string scales. Now, the final idea is to expand upon that type of situation with, using slides to move across positions and so forth, and start developing a more focused sound upon using melodic concepts. Now, that just is, in the early days, going to involve breaking the scale apart. And I did something that really will show something like this in example number 1C. I took the scale layout and I took it across initially the 4th and 5th strings. I've got a shape running like this. Ends off there on the 3rd string, and we're just taking it from G to G. That's still a G major scale layout. There's our G, here's the octave, but we're doing it a slightly different way, covering a lot of ground using a couple strings that are adjacent to one another. It just has a little bit different layout to it. It's not following the exact linear layout of the scale going, G, A, B, C, D. It's not doing that. It's going G, A, and then we're doubling around going here from F sharp to G. And then we're getting the A up to the B, and we're going over grabbing a G to an A. So it's kind of like a sequence concept a little bit. It just continues like that. And then what happened there is after I play an A to a B tone on the 12th and 14th frets of 5th string, I'm going to shoot over and do a D to an E next. So kind of almost like a little bit of pentatonic concept there. And then wrap it up of the taking the F sharp into the octave of G up there. So this is just one example, you know, of how you could do something like this. There's, of course, hundreds more that you could think of. But we're going to take a short break. We're going to come back in a moment and discuss some ideas on linking the scale with longer phrases. So we're going to get more into the melodic aspect of things. The Rhythm Duration Bootcamp program helps solve timing issues by using a two-step learning method. Step one clarifies the most popular rhythms used in today's music. You'll learn the names of the notes and rests as well as their different values and how they're used musically. Step two walks the student through several exercises which apply the notes and rests in rhythmic drills. Rhythm Duration Bootcamp is an easy-to-follow lesson plan that will help to thoroughly develop both the student's feel and their sense of timing. The Rhythm Duration Bootcamp program is available for instant download in the View Our Products area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Well, you know, once you can start to develop the new scale layout concepts and some of the playing techniques that are involved with leaving the traditional in position scale behind, you know, start working on some of these more lateral approaches, you can start working on a more complex task of forming and linking longer melodic guitar lines. Now, this approach involves a number of ideas. So, you know, in getting started, we're going to look at the first concept, which is simply discovering ways that feel comfortable to link the scales together and get a result of a longer melodic passage. So, in example two, I've taken that same, you know, harmony out of G major sound, the melodic line ideas out of G major, and we're going to set up a fretboard concept like this. I've already got it together. Of course, it's in your handout under example two. I would like to start by just playing it for you. It goes like this. Now, it still is quite scalar, you know, it doesn't exactly sound like some super flowing melodic line, but I'm definitely breaking the scale up a lot more. And I think the purpose of really what I'm trying to get across here is working along the neck and allowing for different scale ideas, not being fully, you know, point A to point B, or I should say G to G, root to octave. Don't, you know, getting away from that. You don't want to, you know, work on that too long. You want to start building things that sound cool, you know, and are fun to practice as an idea. And, you know, obviously going into melodies is going to be a lot more fun than just running scales up and down like that. So one more time, here's the example two phrase. It goes like this. So it's got a nice flow to it. Now let's break it down a little bit and just analyze what's happening here. I'm starting on a low G on the 6th string, 3rd fret. And then what I'm doing next is I'm doing a slide idea from the D tone up to an E on 5th string. And then jumping right into the octave of G. So kind of cool little sound there right to out of the start. And then next what I'm doing is getting kind of linear. I'm going F sharp G. So that's 4th fret to 5th fret on the 4th string. And then I'm going to go A to B, 7 to 9 on the same string. So far I've got this. So it sort of sounds linear, but it really isn't, as you can tell. The next thing I'm going to do is go through D, E, and then F sharp, G. So I'm going to work with those notes. And then I'm going to move forward. I'm going to take the E up to an F sharp. And then I'm going to have an A to a B. Moving up to a high D 10th fret, 1st string D. So some interesting movements happening there. Now in that position, I'm going to add, against that D, I'm going to add a C and a B tone underneath on the 2nd string going 13th and 12th frets. Then I'm going to do a slide from below into the 12th fret. I'm going to play D, and I'm going to have C. So I've got this idea happening. Then to wrap everything up, I'm going to take the E tone, 12th fret, 1st string, move up into the F sharp, grab the D, or the G, pardon me, and wrap things up. So there it's quite linear. Here it is all through again. So as you can tell, when you look at the range, first of all, that we're covering, that's a lot of room there. We're going from 3rd fret all the way, like 3rd fret G6 string, all the way to a G found way up there at the 15th fret of the first guitar string. So that's a huge range, first of all, that we're covering. Full octave, you might as well say, across the neck. It's more than that, because when you judge the octaves, you got an octave there, an octave here, so that's our second octave, and you got another octave going up that to that high 15th fret. So that's a lot of range that we're covering, first of all. But it's more so how we're moving across the scale and the kinds of ways that we're getting the notes to function, and also some of the techniques that we're applying as well, because we've got some slides in there. Got hammer on and pull off ideas. And then we've got some other slides up top there. So, when you're working everything across your neck to be able to form and link longer melodic passages, you have to just keep working on ideas to get you started. It's not going to be all that easy, but through the work that you put into it, you're going to start discovering ways that are, most importantly, and this is the word I want you to, or the words I really want you to walk away with, discovering ways that feel comfortable. So feel comfortable. You got to have lines that you work through that feel good to you, because if you've ever learned somebody else's guitar lick off of an album or something, you've gone to maybe do it on the neck and it feels really awkward, sort of strange. Now that's good practice too, because it's going to introduce new techniques and new fingering combinations and so forth to you. So that's great work as well. But when you're trying to work on your own lines and you're trying to develop your own melodic passages and so forth, you got to find the right ideas that work well for you, so that as you practice them, they not only sound cool and they're fun to play and they're good practicing ideas, but they're going to be very natural feeling when you need to bust that idea out live, on stage at a club or something, when you're playing in your top 40 band or whatever you're doing. So always remember that, is you're going for comfort too. There's all kinds of different ways that you can play things on the neck. And if you've been following my Figured Out Fridays videos, the ear training videos that I have on my Guitar Blog Update YouTube channel, I'm sure you've noticed that if you work out and test your chops on ear training, lifting off the assignment that comes out on YouTube on Tuesdays, and you find you come up with a way to play it, and then when I release the answer key on Friday, you're looking at what I did and you're going, wow, that's a really different way of executing this idea on the neck. This is what the guitar is like. It's just an instrument where you have all kinds of different ways of playing things. It's just because we have so many unisons on the neck. We've got, in example, here's an F here, same F there, same F there, same F there. We've got all these identical notes that have different regions of the guitar fingerboard they can be played in. And it's not just notes, of course, it's phrases as well. So this wraps up the first half of the video that's on YouTube. You can check out the second half of this video on the members area, creativeguitarstudio.com. If you haven't pulled out a membership yet for creativeguitarstudio.com, I highly suggest getting it. I'm putting up a lot of information there every month, and it's a really great site. I'm really happy with the way it looks and the way it functions. And in time, as the months and years go on, there's going to be just unbelievable amount of information there. So we're going to catch up next with the second half of this video on the website, and take these ideas much further by starting to really get serious about incorporating the aspect of rhythm into how these lines are going to be built and how they're formed on the guitar fingerboard. So I'll catch up with you next in the members area. Be sure to head over to my website at creativeguitarstudio.com for part two of this lesson in the members area. In part two, I'll be explaining how forming and linking longer guitar lines can be developed even further by using rhythmic concepts to get even more emphasis going with these longer melodies. I'll catch up with you next in the members area at creativeguitarstudio.com. Thanks for watching. Click here to subscribe to the Creative Guitar Studio YouTube channel and never miss another guitar lesson. Click here to sign up for your free membership to creativeguitarstudio.com. And if you take out a paid membership, you'll get premium content, downloads, jam tracks, lesson handouts, and full access to all the members area video lessons. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you next time for another guitar lesson. Bye for now. Head over to my blog site at andrewwasson.com for links to my daily blog posts, and be sure to follow me on Twitter, like me on Facebook, and subscribe to my other guitar blog YouTube channel. All the links are underneath in the show more description box of this video.